I put my hand down in my pocket, pulled out my cell phone and looked at it, and it said, shots have been fired in Copenhagen.
I was starting to see on Facebook that a lot of people were talking about a shooting that had taken place.
The shooting happened after midnight, thank God. Half the guests had left the party, and the security guard came in and asked us to stop the music. And immediately after that, he told us to run to the basement.
Jeg blev dybt, dybt chokeret, og dybt, dybt ulykkelig. Og så bagefter, så kom der altså tingene ligesom, som jeg havde selv oplevet som barn, og i Therese, det kom pludselig væltende tilbage.
We were in shock because, first of all, that it could happen. And second, Danusan was one of my pupils.
In the weeks after, we received emails and phone calls and letters from people all over the world, Jews, non-Jews, Muslims, writing especially to Hannah, saying that nothing should take away, no heinous act should take away what was her great day. And people wrote to me that I should feel no guilt, that I had no responsibility, that, you know, this great outpour of comfort and support, and that was wonderful. Unfortunately, I also received and read and saw comments about how we brought this upon ourselves. These comments came from regular Danes. They didn't come from Muslims. They didn't come from someone who they just came from a regular Danes.
No, I was shocked like everybody else. And I had, you know, talks with colleagues during the following weeks. And it was interesting for me to see that this thing about the attack on the Jewish community, that was really something that frightened people. That was really, you know, that was really to them an eye-opener.
Well, when I try to explain it to my children, who ask, why does such a bad thing happen? I say it's because of hatred. Hatred caused this.
This is a problem we have to address, and politicians have to address it. We have to find a way. We have to find a way to meet this challenge, and that is not only Denmark, that is generally in Europe, period.
I'm nervous about being afraid all the time. And I definitely understand people who start to fear for their life and for their children. This is what terror wishes, that we will think about them all the time, that we will be in fear.
A guy wrote me, a friend of mine who lives in Aarhus, who's a perfect Dane. He's been with the army fighting wars. And one of the things that he had recognized were these peace rings that had taken place under the Arabic Spring in Egypt and Tunis, where Muslims would surround Christians and Christians would surround Muslims when doing prayer. It became obvious that if this was going to happen, that I would take the charge on it, and so it did. The greatest moment was to see all the many different people there standing hand in hand.
On a positive note, I see that there are more people trying to build bridges, trying to make a difference for something good. A Somali woman came up to me and she said to me, I saw you on TV and I just want to say, I'm so sorry for what has happened to you. And you must know, we don't all think like that. We need to do things together, then it'll be better. And she was crying and I was crying, and it was for me a really beautiful moment.
I actually think that it's going to be better. I think that people after the attack have realized we have to start understanding that other person better. And I have experienced from both sides, the Jewish community and the Muslim community, a big interest in fixing things. I think we all can agree to one thing, and it is you really do not want your neighbor to have to live in fear. And if I can help that, then I will.